guys, it's Haff. I am back again, and this is going to be the fourth haul video that I have filmed. Yeah, so went on a bit of a spendy spree. So this haul is from Cosmetic Capital, which is like a discount makeup site online. Some stuff from Audi, and some stuff I think I found at Woolworths. But yeah. So the stuff from Audi I'll do first. They had this biphase micellar. I have two other bottles of micellar sitting over there, one of which is in use. I quite like biphase for removing eye makeup. Yeah, so I thought I'd try this one out and see what it's like. I have one that I'm using, one of the ones I'm using at the moment. I don't really like it. It's a little stingy on the eyes, so I'm hoping that one is better. I also got this, which is a cleansing foam. It looks like a clear liquid, but it's one of those foaming pump things. I like foaming cleansers. Not everybody does, but I do. This one has aloe vera, cucumber, and provitamin B5 in it. And then I got these two lip products. So a matte lip stick in Heartbreaker, which is kind of like a mauve from what I can work out. Can't really tell because I haven't opened it. And they had a lip oil in there the other day. So this one is a hydrating one. So I thought I would try it out and see what it's like. From Woolies, I got two of the Revlon, these were on discount, Revlon Ultra HD Matte Lip Colours. So this one is in Infatuation and this one is in Addiction. I have the greeny blue one and I quite like that. So I thought I would grab these two, seeing as how they were going cheap. Revlon is not cheap in Australia. So from Cosmetic Capital, I bought a shitload of stuff. I have had a whole bunch of stuff in my cart on Cosmetic Capital for months, and every now and then I go in there and there'll be stuff that's no longer in stock because it is a discount, like end of run type of place. And so I will clear those things out and then I'll add some new things. And unfortunately, because I didn't buy my cart when I should have, I could have, if I'd done it like 3 months ago, I could have got a whole bunch of Barry M nail polishes, but I only ended up with one, because all the rest of them were sold out. So the one Barry M that I did end up getting is one of the coconut infusion ones. This is in Starfish. So it's just a nude, light beige kind of colour. I had a whole bunch of these other ones like 3 or 4 months ago and I just didn't have the funds. Also on the makeup line, I got this Ulta 3 Nice List. It's a little, it's like the, a Christmas gift type thing from the gel-like polisher line, which is not any better in my personal opinion than their normal line. They're basically exactly the same. You just pay slightly more when you buy these ones individually. So there are 5 of them in this pack, plus a nail file, which I took out and gave to my friend before she left, and she put it down before she left and left it here. People. So this one is called Tinsel, which is the weirdest name, honestly. It's grey. Why is this Tinsel? This is not a Tinsel colour. That one does not make any sense. Then we have Wish. These need shaking. They are separated. So this one is Wish. This one definitely needs shaking. This is called Star. It's a very pale pink with a shimmer in it. When you see separation like that, it doesn't mean your polish is bad. It just means it needs a really, really good shake. And then we have Cookie, which is a very pale brown, basically. And then we have a glitter topper thing, which, that's really interesting. This is called Sugar Plum. It had some big old glitters in it, but then it has these really micro fine. You'd be able to get this one fully opaque, I reckon, because of those microfine glitters that are kind of green against the rose gold. Super interesting. I have three other nail polishes. So this one from Revlon Colours Day. This is a wild card. It's just a basic blue. Then I have two from Essie's gel-like line, which are pretty good. I have one other one of them, and I really like them. This one needs a really good shake. This one is Zip Me Up, which is a minty green, very pale minty green. Definitely need a new minty green colour. And this one is Twill Seeker, which I have had in their regular line. I think I still have it in their regular line. This is a purple with a green shift to it. It's gorgeous. Gorgeous. And then we have... So I bought four foundations. I don't know if the colours are right. That's the problem with buying them online. Anyway, the CoverGirl Stay Luminous. This is in 810, which is Classic Ivory. Should be alright. I got the LA Colours Radiant. I prefer a luminous, radiant, hydrating type of foundation. Matte foundations look like shit most of the time on me. So this one is in Ivory. And then they had Wet n Wild's Photo Focus foundation. So I got two of them. I got Rose Ivory and Soft Ivory because they were the two that looked least yellow, particularly the Rose Ivory. Rose with Ivory means it's got a pink undertone. The Soft Ivory should have basically no undertone. It should be fairly neutral. But we'll see. If they oxidize, they're probably going to look terrible. Oh, there was another foundation. It's just that it came in a box and I forgot. This is the... Oops, there are two of them in the... Confusing. That's right, I bought two of them. The Revlon Youth FX Fill and Blur Foundation. I got that in porcelain and in ivory. I figure if one of them's too light or the other one's too dark, I can mix them together. So a whole bunch of new foundations, but I have nearly finished one foundation that I've been using for most of the year. So anyway, also from Wet n Wild, I got the Mega Glow English Illuminating Palette. So that is really cool. It's got like four different tones in it. I'd probably just swirl them all together. Isn't that what people would do? I definitely need more coffee. Okay, alrighty, I got a Baby Roll mascara, but it's blue, it's in indigo, because I like a coloured mascara. I got some pencils. So I have, Satin is a brand that, it's like super cheap, but it's decent. I have several of their pencils. So this one is Chianti, so it's quite brown. This one is Genoa, which is more almost a terracotta. So I got those two lip liners. Then I got this eye pencil from them in charcoal. I do like a good grey eyeshadow eyeliner. Then I got a Maybelline Colour Show coal liner. It's actually meant for eyes. It is in the colour Coralista. So it's like orange. So that's interesting. They had a NYX lip primer. So I think I've actually got one of these in my collection already, but it was cheap. So, a Maybelline Master Camo crayon, like one of the corrector crayons. This is in purple, but I figured you could use it for other things other than just using it. Oh, it actually says blue, but it also says fair to light skin tones, so we will see. They had a whole bunch of J-Cat stuff, and I was originally going to buy a whole bunch of J-Cat stuff, but in the end, I pretty much just got this one. I'm pretty sure it's the only J-Cat thing I've got in here. Yeah. This is the Holographic Lip Cream in... Why do I have to tape everything? I can't get in. This one is in Solar Eclipse. Which, I don't know if you can see the flash. It's got like this red flash, but it looks like brown. So weird. So weird, but really interesting. I picked up a L'Oreal Lip Paint Lacquer in Fuchsia Walls. I picked up three of the NYX, what do they call them? Cosmic Metals. I already have the purple one. So this one is Electromagnetic, which is green. This one is Galactic, which is grey. And this one is Solar Energy, which is orange with a pink flash. So, and I really enjoy the purple one, so I figured I'd enjoy those. I got a Milani Stellar Light Holographic Lip Gloss. It's not holographic, it's iridescent. But it's blue to pink shifting. It's called Iridescent Blue. Don't tell me it's holographic and then call it iridescent. And I picked up an LA Colors Glitter Magic. This is one of those lipsticks that you put it on and it doesn't look very special, and then you press your lips together and it's got glitter everywhere. This one is in Starry Night. This is the LA Girls version of it, not the Ciate version of it. Much cheaper for a start. And lastly, but by no means leastly, I have four NYX Duo Chromatic lipsticks. These are toppers. These are not, they have no, like, they're not pigmented enough to be anything else, because they're basically white. So I have all, I think there was four in the collection. I think I have all of them. So this one is Damn. That's literally what it says. Damn. That's weird. No idea. I don't know which way this one shifts. I can't really tell. Then we have Chill Chill. See, from a distance, that one looks, in like my viewfinder, that one looks blue. That one doesn't really look like anything. We have So Anti, which looks pinkish. And then we have As If, which I don't know. Yeah, I just thought they were really interesting. I have no idea if they're any good. Let me experiment there if I can get one open. Okay. So, that's what it looks like. Yeah, not much to see. That is awesome. I've now got it all over this, but that is awesome. That's cool. I love that. Okay, that is it for this video. And for whole videos. I think I have like 5 of them in all going up in the next week or so. Yeah. So if you want to subscribe, click the button down there. Click the little bell if you want to get notified when I upload your content. Leave me a thumbs up if you like haul and makeup type videos. And leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments. And I'll see you in my next video. See ya.